I got my X480 charger today, so I'll be doing an unboxing video of the same. Now, right out of the box, you can see the charger speakers over here. Then it's 4 port, 80 watts per port, that's 320 watts and all. You have your X480 name over here. It can charge 6L LiPo, 6L Life, 6L Lion, 1-15 NiCad, 1-15 Nano AMH, and some PV batteries as well. These are the lead acid batteries, by the way. On the other side, you just have your marking, that is the Hi-Tech X480. On the same side, it's here as well. On this page, you can see the pick of the charger with some of its accessories. It includes a DC input cable, battery clamps, Tamiya chargers, and etc. So now we'll open it up. And I think so. Okay, that's fine. So, since we have got a charger out now, we can see it's come in a nice box. Even if someone threw it, I don't think so they'll be able to damage it up right now. So we'll open this thing up. As soon as you open it, we can see a manual over here. So the manual in itself, Hi-Tech is known to write, writing good manuals and all. So I think so it's just a cycle chart that they have given, maybe. Yeah, so these are your cycling charts, your warnings, etc, etc. Then when you come over here, I'll just keep it further aside. When you come over here, you have your balancing port. This is another balancing port that you have, the third one. So one of these one is basically used via a normal Unitology batteries. I think so one is of the Thunder Power as well. So we'll keep them aside. Coming to the connectors. Okay, one is connected over there. Coming to the connectors, we have the following items. Okay, it has been ziplocked. So, on the connecting parts, we have the following things. You have your alligator clips. You will just plug in your banana port over here into this one, the red and the black one. Then you have a further clips. I'll just open them up. Just a second. Okay, so we have first one are for your GST connectors. I think so these one are for the transmitter or the RX ones. We'll keep this aside. Then we have Tamiya ones. I don't think so anybody uses them anymore. I don't know. I don't. We have an unsoldered one, so I can put my Deans on this one. Coming up, we have alligator clips one. I think so this can be used for a DC power supply. Further up, we have a second unsoldered one. So quite good. Nice amount of packaging they have given. Now coming to the charger itself. Right out of the box, it's quite heavy. It has nice weight to it. Packet is over here, nice one. Now, one thing that I want to make sure and talk about a bit. So these are your banana plugs. Yeah, this won't fit into one of your normal power sockets. You'll need a power supply for this one. So if you don't have a power supply or you're not intending to buy a power supply, please do not buy this one. Buy the Hi-Tech X480 AC-DC Plus. Now, since let's see the charger first. Okay, over here we have two of our connections. One over here and one set over here. Then the same thing is over here. You have your balancing ports, your PC link for the temperature, your cooling fan, and there's a nice big heatsink on the back side of it. Now some of the things that I will highly recommend is you're buying a power supply. Now this charger is able to charge things at 320 watts, that is 80 watts in 4 channels, so it's 320 watts. Buy a power supply from Hobby King, which is at around 350 watts. Now this will supply at around 25 amps. The maximum amperage that this one will use is, if I'm not mistaken, maybe 20 amps. So buy one of these, quite good. They'll be with you forever. So this will be a power supply for this one. Secondly, like me, if you're using your only these batteries, are your primary batteries, such as say these ones, what do you call them, Tonigy ones. Buy one of this balancing port, so these one is included in this, buy two more, so that would be good enough for you. And rest assured, this is a good charger. I have seen one of them working around. I'll be posting a review as soon as possible. So take care, guys. Bye.